Hey, so I don't even want to set up lights or anything for this because I am super upset. I just finished The Secret Commonwealth by Philip Pullman, one of my most anticipated books. I mean, what is there to anticipate? I didn't like the first book, but I liked the original series a lot. Did I want to give the lowest rating of the year to the sequel of my favorite series? No, I did not, but here we are. I don't even know if I have anything to say about it or if I have too much to say about it. I also didn't care much for La Belle Sauvage, but I didn't think it was terrible. But I do think this one is absolutely terrible. So this one takes place 20 years after the events of La Belle Sauvage and 10 years after the events of His Dark Materials. So here Lyra is like 20 years old, and Malcolm from the first book is like 30 years old. I don't even know what to say about the plot of this book. It's like, what is the fucking plot of this book? Seriously. The New York Times said it's a stunning achievement. This universe Pullman has created and continues to build. That's fucking bullshit. The plot of this book is like a bunch of rich guys out of like special rose water to just wash their hands or something. And then everyone's like, oh, like there is some secret to this rose water. And then the Magisterium is like, oh, like we must get the rose water resources because it's like super important. And like, why is this important? Because dust. So the book starts with some sort of an interesting premise as far as the character goes. So there is some sort of tension between Lyra and Pantalaimon. Like, the tension is so serious, they don't even maybe like each other anymore. They don't speak to each other. And at first I was like, oh, like, is this gonna be brilliant? Because are we dealing with something like depression or self-deprecation? These are topics these books have never explored, but just having a part of your soul with you at all times as a companion. I thought it was a great opportunity maybe to talk about self-hatred and just losing confidence in yourself. I had all these things going on in my mind and I was like, oh wow, this is just, where is this thing gonna go? But like, it's quickly revealed that it's just Lyra reads some books and Pantalaimon is not happy with those books. He doesn't like those books because of those books. Now Lyra lost her imagination, whatever the fuck that means. So like, Pantalaimon goes to find Lyra's imagination, and Lyra goes to find Pantalaimon, and then Malcolm goes to find Lyra. It's just like incredible mess. Oh, also, guess what? You know that super important thing in the first books that demons and humans cannot separate? I guess that's not a thing. That's a completely trivialized in this book, because literally everyone can separate. If you just try a little bit hard enough, if you try hard enough, then you can separate from your demon. And why was it such a big deal in the first books that they were trying to separate kids from their demons? They had like this whole weird machine that like has like an incision, whatever, to separate demons from the kids. What was the point of all that? I get there was no point to that because anyone can separate from their demons, but not in the first series. Even though the first series took place in a much larger universe, there was like not a single person who could do that except for witches. So you would think that would be just a thing for witches, but no, it's for everyone. Everyone can separate from their demons if they just like try hard enough. Also, like from the La Belle Sauvage, the only thing I really liked was the relationship between Malcolm and Alice. Like, that book spent so much time developing that relationship and it had a really good payoff. And then guess what? It doesn't matter at all because Alice got married to someone else and then they're like friends. And Malcolm is in love with Lyra. Okay, fine. Like, I will accept the age difference. There's like a 10-year age difference and they were both kids when they met. But Malcolm is a professor at the Jordan College and Lyra is a student there. So Malcolm has been her teacher for quite some time now, and Lyra is 20 years old now. When did Malcolm realize he was in love with Lyra? Was it last year? It better be last year. And here's the thing, at the beginning of this book, they don't have much of a relationship between them. The only relationship they had was teacher-student relationship. Lyra didn't even know anything about what happened in the first book, where Malcolm saved her and everything. But like now, suddenly, Malcolm is in love with Lyra. They literally started speaking in this book. Malcolm has been avoiding Lyra before the events of this book. And then the villain of this book is Lyra's uncle? Because he has some sort of a weird feud with Lyra, because she caused her sister to die? That makes no sense. How immature and childish you are. This guy is like 50 years old. How childish can you get? He blames Lyra for the death of Miss Coulter. Like, I just can't. I cannot even with this book. And these are not even the worst things about this book. They're like traveling east to go to this city where they grow these roses. And then there's like another city where only demons live, whatever, to find those places. They're just traveling there. So what you can learn from that adventure to east is you always find your expats, Western expats, whenever you're visiting east, because those are the people that's gonna help you. This book is pretty strongly anti-religion, but if you go to east, still find your friendly expat priest, because those are the people that are gonna help you. Otherwise, as a woman, if you're traveling by yourself, you're gonna get sexually assaulted by a large group of men. I mean, sexual assault scenes are always hard to talk about when it comes to their necessity in a book. Is there ever a necessary sexual assault scene? But if there is, this is certainly not that scene. It is absolutely pointless. It's absolutely disgusting. It's like towards the end of the book, like it will not affect anything except for demonizing this Eastern place. I don't know about you, but I'm sick of seeing that. Thankfully, there are trusted Western expats all around the world so that you can trust them. But that scene kind of sealed the deal for me. I don't want to say more about it because maybe it's already a spoiler, but I don't want to say more about it so that you can get disgusted on your own. Another thing is, do you remember Malcolm's migraine from the first book? That was like absolutely pointless. Every now and then, conveniently, he had a migraine. He would have this aura that would direct him to a certain place or whatever. Yeah, that still exists in this book. Again, extremely conveniently, suddenly, Malcolm gets his migraine and his aura points him to important places. Don't you wish your migraine was like that? That would be super convenient. But that convenience only belongs to Malcolm and nothing else comes out of it again. That's just it. It's just there's this one scene where he gets his convenient migraine again. So like that's the deus ex machina for this book. Malcolm's migraine is the deus ex machina of this new series. Whenever we need to get to somewhere and we don't know what to do, Malcolm can get a migraine so that the migraine can lead it to where he needs to go. And like in the East, they trade in US dollars. It was weird to me because in these series, the US does not have a lot of influence. I don't even know it's the US because I think Texas is its own country. Like, I don't even know much about how America works generally in this world. But I guess they have a huge influence in the East because people trade in US dollars. Other than that, a lot of this book is like sitting in cafes and just chatting. I'm really having a hard time saying anything good about this book. I got so disappointed and I wasn't hopeful after La Belle Sauvage, but I was excited to see Lyra. Oh, Lyra, yes. Your favorite super smart, rebellious, adventurous girl that could get out of every situation with her wits. Lyra Silvertongue. In this book, she's like the dullest, most boring character ever. Look, I understand people grow up and change, but I really don't want to read about a dull Lyra. I don't know who asked for this. And again, I would understand if there was like a stronger reason behind the difficulties in her relationship with Pantalaimon, but there isn't. It's just because she lost her imagination. I think there's only one person who lost his imagination, and that's Philip Pullman. And again, I don't know what the point of the first book was, La Belle Sauvage, because I don't know if there's a lot you bring from that book into Malcolm's character either, because Malcolm was like this curious detective-like kid. And in this book, he's just like a teacher. I mean, nothing wrong with being a teacher, but like, what was the point of everything that happened in the first book if we were not setting up Malcolm for something grand? He doesn't even have a boat anymore. What was the point of La Belle Sauvage? And since the first book of this series has barely any impact, imagine what impact the original series have on this series. That's right, none at all. All this huge grand adventure they went on, it was for nothing. Did they not see all those incredible supernatural events? They've seen witches and armored polar bears and traveled between dimensions, and suddenly Lyra doesn't have her imagination anymore. Suddenly she started to question if demons are real because she read a book. I guess I can say one good thing about this book, and that's the audiobook. It's read by Michael Sheen and he does a phenomenal job. It's incredibly well performed. That was really the only thing that made this book bearable. I'm upset. I really at least wanted this to be a little bit better than La Belle Sauvage. I think some things are just best left alone. Why do we need this sequel? Who asked for this? But I would love to know your thoughts if you read this and loved this book, because what is the freaking Goodreads on this? My Goodreads rating is 1. Wow, this book has like 4.26 on Goodreads. Over 5,000 ratings. Most people like this book. So I want to know why you like this book. Please enlighten me. I would love to be wrong about this book. I want to like this book. This is one of my favorite series. Lyra is one of my favorite characters of all time. But you know what? I'm going to move on. And since the new TV adaptation of His Dark Materials just came out, I will make videos on that. I'll just go back to the original series and I will try to forget that this ever happened. Thanks for staying with me in this shitty video. I hope you can join me in some of the other better videos. I will talk more about the pointless or even creepy Malcolm-Lyra relationship in my upcoming fantasy relationships tier lists 2019 part 2 video. You can watch part 1 right now. I will link it in the description. That is a better video. So that this shitty video and that decent video can cancel each other. Anyway, thanks for staying with me until the end of this video. And if you'd like to see more videos on the better His Dark Materials universe books, don't forget to subscribe, and I'll see you next time. I am